Kia ora. You as a carer are an unsung hero of the health system. It's usually someone like you, an unpaid family member or friend who carries out the long-term job of being a carer at home. Stroke happens suddenly and there is little that can prepare someone for the role of carer. Caring for a person who has had a stroke can be a rewarding and satisfying experience. However, it can also be physically and emotionally exhausting. Feeling stressed and challenged by the situation is normal and natural. A really important part of your journey as a carer is that you take care of your own well-being and build your resilience to cope with the challenges that come along.
I became a carer when Margaret had a stroke during the night, a serious stroke during the night, and that was 9 years ago last August.
My story started in 2018 when my mum had a stroke. And my starting years with mum, it was really hard because I was caring for my mum and I was actually working at the same time with our business.
The difficulties that we have as family carers coming into the situation, certainly at the beginning, is that we haven't got any training in this. I didn't understand really what had happened. And if you're not resilient and you haven't got that get up and go to be able to pursue things, it's going to be very difficult. You certainly have to be a positive thinker. You have to be a strong advocate, and I don't think you can be an advocate without doing some research.
There's actually a lot to do with caring for a stroke patient. I had to learn from physios and learn from people that have been through it. You know, it took me about 3 months to get used to doing what I was doing. But there's actually a lot of support from family and we're able to get a carer.
Margaret had a large number of friends, so the girls very early on rallied around. But it doesn't last forever. And I think the carer, the family carer, has to realise it. It took me a while to get to grips with the fact that the friends drop off. I found that in my situation, Margaret doesn't quite understand the stresses that I go through as a carer. But for strategies for yourself, you've got to make some me time. And if you've got an interest, all the better. 51 years in the motor industry meant I've got a loving of motor cars. Once I learnt a bit more about respite care and I saw that, you know, to be fair, I was entitled to it, I did then pursue it. You actually need to unwind. And I found in my instance that I wasn't comfortable with just being here at home. That I have found for respite breaks, I need to get out of town.
Time out for me is really important, you know, because then it makes me gain more strength to come back and look after mum. Mainly in my time out, I go do my shopping, or I like to go to a mall.
When they've had a stroke, it's a different person. It's not the person you first met or married, it's a different person. And the relationship kind of changes. It gets replaced with something good as well, but it just changes. And I think it's uncomfortable in some ways to introduce new places or new things. But we've gone for our full 2 weeks into the Sunshine Coast of Australia. We go to Melbourne first and see our son. We've done that twice a year since she's had a stroke. And that's quite good for us as a couple because that's what we did as a couple.
You just gotta have faith and believe that, you know, you can do it and just treat them with care and love. The more love you give them, the more respect they will have for you. And you have to be strong and have patience to go through it.
I think it's shown that I've had the strength that I've needed to be able to carry out the role, and it's made me a lot more determined to achieve what I want to achieve. I think it just helps you develop your own personal attributes, and I think that's your reward, really, in a way, that you've become a better person to some extent.
Being a carer for my mum is like a normal thing that a daughter would do for their parents. When you were a child, they cared for you and they loved you. And that's why now I'm paying back the respect that I have for my parents. And I reckon looking after my mum has been one of the greatest experiences of my life.
As you can see, everyone has their own unique experiences. Throughout your own journey, you will become an expert on how to take care of your own health and well-being, depending on your personal situation and your strengths. Here are 5 tips to help build your resilience and take care of yourself while caring for your loved one. Equip yourself with knowledge and find out as much as you can about stroke and what to expect in terms of rehabilitation and recovery. Build a network of family, friends, and professionals to give you practical and emotional support, and reach out for help early. Take advantage of services like respite care. Discuss with the person you care for how the relationship will work to ensure that your role and your own needs are respected. Maintain a healthy lifestyle and eat healthy meals, exercise regularly and get enough sleep. Make time for yourself to do the things you enjoy. And be proud of the amazing job you do and the expertise you have developed to be a resourceful and effective problem solver. Get in touch with our Community Stroke Advisor team for further advice and support. You can phone us on 0800 STROKE, that's 0800 787653, or go to our website, stroke.org.nz.